Good day, viewers, and you are welcome to our today's lesson on science. And the topic for discussion today is community health, and it is for grade 9. So let's look at this introduction here about health. Good health is important in keeping us alive and fit to carry out our daily activities properly. In grade 7, we have learned about personal hygiene. In this lesson, we will study community health problems and ways of solving them. The difference between personal health and community health is impossible to break, and they affect each other. That is personal health and community health are too interconnected, so you cannot separate them easily. Personal health refers to health at individual level, that is health at individual level, and community health refers to health at larger society. Since it is individuals living together that make up the community. Good, so let's move up. As a matter of fact, it is our individual attitudes, behaviors, and actions that add up to influence the general health of the society. Sometimes this influence can be destructive. Example, when it results in epidemic. This means an outbreak and widespread of a disease within a population. Many of these diseases are caused by tiny organisms called microbes. Thousands of these microbes are found everywhere in our environment. They are found in homes, workplaces, marketplaces, garages, etc., etc. When these organisms get into our bodies through breathing, eating, or through cuts in the skin, they make us ill or sick. Although these disease-causing organisms are found around us, certain conditions in our environment are favorable for their growth and spread. The identification of these conditions and thus to prevent the spread of diseases by such organisms is the main concern of this lesson. Each community has its own specific health problems, and some of this may be temporary. However, there are some health problems that are both epidemic and endemic. That is, they are very widespread, that is endemic, and firmly established in the community, that is endemic. An example is malaria. This disease is widespread because it affects every community in the Gambia and even beyond. It is firmly established because it has been with us for generations. Identifying general health problems. Identifying general health problems. So this will involve an activity. And in this activity, it involves a visit to the community to observe and identify some general health problems. The places we will visit include streets, some compounds, household and community toilets, marketplaces, garages, sources of drinking water, etc., etc. Two, then back in class, activity two, back in class, we will discuss the identified health problems and how it affects the community, community members, and ways of solving them. So this will be our activity for today in this lesson. So we can start our activity now. We go into town now. And the first place we come across is in this street here. And look at what we see here. Then let's record everything we see here. Then when we go back to class, we discuss what we see. Okay, so look at the picture very carefully. Again, we have come across this place also. And look at what is happening here also. And take note of everything. Here we are again at another location. And look at also what happens here. Get down your points so that we can go back to class and discuss whatever we saw here. Okay. We are here again, another place. So look at everything that is happening here, everything that you see here. You record down everything. And then we discuss whatever we see. Then we go back to class. So watch the picture very carefully. Okay. Here also we come across a vendor and look at what is happening on the food he is selling. Okay, so record everything that you saw here also for discussion in the classroom. Another food vendor and look at what is happening also with the food. So we record down what you see here as well. We come across this location also. So observe this place very well and write down what you see here. Okay. Look at everything in the picture and get down whatever you see. So now some of the identified health problems that we saw in the town or in the community are here. The first one we come across was unhygienic disposal of waste. This involves indiscriminate or senseless throwing away of unwanted used materials in the surroundings. Many of the things that we throw away as waste, known as refuse, provide the right condition for disease-causing organisms to grow on them. Insects that spread microbes from person to person also feed on this refuse and breed in them. So it is important to be careful in the way we dispose of refuse. Okay, so that's number one problem, unhygienic disposal of waste. Now let's look at types of waste or refuse which are disposed of in our community that we come across when we went for the visit. So this includes, as we see, one, kitchen and domestic waste. Kitchen and domestic waste. This consists of wood ashes, animal and vegetable waste materials from the kitchen, plastic and paper wrappings, stale leftover food, empty tins and cans, etc., etc. They are often called solid waste. Solid waste. So don't forget that. Okay. The second type of waste that we come across is excretory waste. Excretory waste. This consists of feces and urine. It consists of feces and urine. Thirdly, sanitary waste. This is waste water from the kitchen, bathroom, or bath place, and also from laundry. So basically, these were the three types of refuse or waste that we come across in the community. So here are various examples of the pictures we have taken from the visit. So look at this, it's a waste, it's from a construction or carpentry site. So it's a type of waste called solid waste. Look at here, also look at this picture. We come across all these type of waste along the street. All these are solid waste, okay? You have come across all such things. All these are waste and they were just thrown indiscriminately around the community. These are also waste and they include, this type of waste are called medical waste. They come from mostly hospitals and clinics, okay? The same also, all these are medical waste that are normally thrown around the streets in the community. The same way, solid waste around town. Again, look at the picture, the same. All these are waste that we have seen around town. Solid waste, the same thing on this picture also, okay? We have seen this type of waste also. What type of waste do you think is this? These are excretory waste, okay? From the bathrooms that form the feces and urine. Excretory waste, and they found their way into the gutters, okay? Still, again, excretory waste, all this form part of excretory waste from the toilets. They consist of feces and urine, okay? The same, again, excretory waste coming from bathrooms that find their waste into gutters, okay? So now, let's look at the problems associated with the way in which waste or refuse are disposed of. Problems associated with the way in which waste or refuse are disposed of. In most communities, household refuse are stored in a variety of containers, such as buckets, pans, curtains, and disposable empty rice bags. Further collection and disposal of household waste by cleansing services is often delayed or non-existent. This usually results to either accumulation of refuse in the households or indiscriminate dumping of household waste at unofficial sites in the community. Refuse collection and disposal at marketplaces, garages, and other public places is inadequate. Consequently, solid waste are left to accumulate in such areas. Now let's look at the problems associated with the improper solid refuse disposal. Point one, it encourages vectors, that is animals that carry disease-causing organisms from filthy places to humans, such as rats and flies, to feed on refuse and breed in it. Rats transmit microbes that cause a disease called plague, while flies carry the germs that cause cholera and other bacteria to food. Point two, during rainy season, empty tins and cans among refuse heaps and those indiscriminately thrown in the surrounding, collect water, which provide breeding place for mosquitoes. Mosquitoes transmit microbes that cause malaria. Point three, accumulated refuse also produces bad and unhealthy odors. Point four, accumulated solid refuse provides a dwelling place for snakes and other dangerous animals. We come across another aspect, public health problems associated with excretory waste disposal. Public health problems associated with excretory waste disposal. Excretory waste disposal is a serious public health concern in both urban and rural areas. One, open pit latrines. Open pit latrine is the commonest way of disposing of feces and urine. Such latrines can cause community health problems if they are not properly managed. Flies move in and out of pit latrines. In this way, they become contaminated with microbes. The same flies may later settle on food. The same flies may later settle on food intended for human consumption. The food may in turn become contaminated. Point two, pale latrines are also used in some communities. These are buckets which people use to go to toilet. The buckets are then collected at night by health workers, and the contents are disposed of. Pale toilets cause similar community health problems as pit latrines if they are not well kept. Point three, in some places, insanitary waste, often in the form of liquid waste, are drained off into open gutters, which empties into rivers. But most of the time, gutters are blocked with all sorts of solid, hindering the flow of the liquid water. Stagnant water is a perfect breeding place for mosquitoes. Good. Now, another community health problem that we come across in the town is the sale of foodstuff in unhygienic conditions. The sale of foodstuff in unhygienic conditions. So as you may see from the picture, look, there's a vendor who is selling food, but the environment is not that hygienic. So it's a community health problem. We have come across all this in the town where vendors are selling in unhygienic conditions. Okay. Again, we have come across all these things in the community where foodstuffs are sold in unhygienic conditions. As we see from the picture here also, the food items here are not in a very good hygienic condition. So it's a community health issue. The same food being sold under unhygienic conditions also, by looking at the picture, you may see it clearly. The same picture, the same thing, food's been sold under unhygienic conditions. serious community health problem. This picture is showing the same thing. Foods being sold under unhygienic conditions. Okay. The same is shown here. Look at the picture also here. It's the same thing we are seeing. Foods being sold under unhygienic conditions. This picture is showing the same thing. Foods being prepared and sold under unhygienic conditions. All right. Now the sale of foodstuff in unhygienic conditions. The condition in which food is sold in the urban markets and markets found in rural towns are a community health concern. Foodstuff and prepared food for sale are often produced in ways that make them safe for humans to consume. However, most of the time, vendors in the markets and other public places, such as garages, schools, etc., are found selling food items in conditions in which flies and dust can settle on them. This may result in food contamination and subsequent outbreak and widespread of diseases such as cholera and diarrhea. Another community health problem is unsafe drinking water. So look at the picture here again. You may see something here. What is this? There are wells, and what is just next to the wells there? There are latrines or toilets. So this is very unhygienic because the water from the refuse or waste from the toilets may contaminate the water, which is very unsafe to drink. Okay. So unsafe drinking water. River and stream water can be contaminated with all sorts of microbes, especially where people bath, launder, and urinate. Fetching drinking water directly from such sources of water can lead to health problems such as cholera, diarrhea, dysentery, etc. Throwing laundry water close to the mouth of a well can cause muddy water containing germs to slip into the well, especially if the edge is not raised. This may contaminate the well water. Again, other community health problems include, apart from the ones we just explained previously, one, poorly ventilated and overcrowded houses. This may lead to spread of respiratory and skin diseases. Overcrowdedness in houses may cause respiratory and skin diseases. Two, smoking cigarettes in public places often forces non-smokers to breathe in smoke produced by smokers. There is some public health risk involved in this, particularly in enclosed situations. This is why smoking cigarettes, otherwise tobacco, in public is banned by law in the Gambia and many other places. So, ways to solve community health problems. What are some of the ways we can adopt to solve community health problems? So, look at this picture here. Look at what is happening there. There are foodstuffs and they are all canned. so that they can be preserved and protected, thereby avoiding microbes to contaminate them. Okay, so this is one important way to solve community health problems, selling food in very hygienic conditions and preserved form. Okay. All these are ways that can solve community health problems. Look at the picture again here. Look at the foods. They are well kept, okay, and screened and put in containers and covered. Again, the foods being sold here the same are well protected and covered to avoid contamination with microbes. The same way, the foodstuffs are all covered, so this prevents them being coming in contact with microbes that may cause diseases. Another very important way to solve community health problems is proper management of refuse or waste. Proper management of refuse or waste. So the picture is showing you that the waste here are properly manage. They are not discriminately thrown away or senselessly thrown around the streets or in the community. Same again, how we manage the waste or refuse. Okay, we should be able to put our refuse in containers and separate them, sort them out. Separate the papers, the glass, the plastics, and the metals from each other. So all this can be then later recycled. So that will minimize most of the community health problems we encounter in the community due to indiscriminate or senseless throwing away of waste. Now let's look at this quickly. Ways to solve community health problems. One, the household members should use large and strong containers that have tight fitting lids to store domestic solid waste, as we just see from the previous slide here, the same, and here, okay? This will prevent odor coming out of the refuse and discourage rats and flies before collection and disposal by cleansing services. Two, community members should embark on regular cleaning exercise that will remove solid waste from streets, gutters, markets, garages, and so on. Three, at individual level, each member of the community should stop throwing waste papers, plastic bags, and other rubbish indiscriminately. There should be dust bins and waste paper bins at strategic points in the village or town, or even in the school. Keep your fruit peelings, food wrapping, used plastic bags, and all other waste materials until you find a dustbin or an official dump site. Four, public and household pit latrines and pail latrines should not be near wells, kitchens, and other places where food is prepared or sold. They should be kept clean and covered at all times. This will prevent spread of diseases by flies and cockroaches. Five, food vendors, that is, those who sell meat, fish, vegetables, and prepared food, should keep their food items away from flies and dust. This will avoid food contamination and health problems. It is important to screen food vendors for communicable diseases before they are allowed to sell food. 6. Educating community members on health matters. Educating community members on health matters. If people in a community do not know how diseases are spread or how they may be prevented, the standard of health of the community will not improve much. So far, we have come to the end of the lesson almost, but before we wrap up, we have a short homework. Write it down. You do it at home. When we meet again another time, we discuss it together. So the homework is, number one, what is meant by personal health? What is meant by personal health? 2, what is meant by community health? What is meant by community health? 3, how is community health different from personal health? How is community health different from personal health? 4, why do we need to keep our surroundings and public places clean? Why do we need to keep our surroundings and public places clean? So viewers, this brings us to the end of our lesson for this topic, and I thank you all for your kind attention.